Okay, what is up, guys? Welcome back to Archi Hacks. And today we're going to be taking a look at making BIG diagram or big diagram. Now, Big is famous for using their diagrams to explain their buildings and concepts to non-professionals. And it's interesting because their buildings are very iconic because they just look like their diagrams. And these diagrams are usually presented in this axonometric format. And they're very intuitive in such a way that even non-professionals can easily understand. And they end up having this very interesting and iconic look, which makes Big a very interesting architect in the field right now. Now, and today we're going to be taking a look at creating this diagram using Rhino. I've seen some tutorials online but using other software such as SketchUp and Photoshop, but today we'll be using pure Rhino and Illustrator, which is the way we actually do it at Big. Now, let's take a look. First off, I'm going to be using VF57 as our example project. So we'll steal some dimensions out of here. So I'm in Google Earth right now, and it's fully modeled in 3D. And I'll take out the ruler tool to measure the sides of the building to get the actual dimensions. So the long side, it seems to be about 150 meters. And the short side is approximately 60 meters. So I'll be using those dimensions for the base. And secondly, I need the height of the building. So I quickly Googled VF57 height and turns out to be 467 foot. And I've translated that to meters. So it's approximately 140 meters. Now I'll get to Rhino and let's start modeling. First off, the podium is about 150 meters long and 60 meters wide and about 10 meters tall. And I'll click that and turn on the solid points on. I'll take one corner and raise it by 130 meters. That brings us to a total of 140. Now we're in millimeters right now, so I'll just quickly go into options, units, and changes to meters. Say okay. And I should say no in such a way that the scale stays the same, but only the unit changes. So as you can see, the short side is 60 meters and everything is good. Now, right now we're missing the courtyard, so I'll just go to the top view and start copying this out. So first off, I'll trace the outline of the building like so, and I'll click the new geometry and type in offset surface. Now, I'll first off flip the direction because we want the courtyard to be smaller than our building, and the distance will be about 18 meters. And hit enter one more time. And once we delete the outside original geometry, you'll see the new geometry that was offsetted from the original. Now this geometry is about 18 meters offset from the outside of our site, which gives us 18 meter depth of the slab, which is typical for a residential building. Now here's a full model of the VF57. Now what we're gonna do is, first off, switch our perspective to axonometric, parallel view, and place our perspective just right so that we can see the courtyard and the building in a presentable way, like so. Alright, that looks pretty close. Okay. Now I'll select the geometry and type in make 2D. And I'll maintain source layers. It doesn't really matter because when you have one layer, everything looks good. Say okay. Now you get these set of curves, which are projection of what we were looking at in perspective. As you can see, if you pull it out a little bit, this is 2D geometry that looks just like what we can see in perspective. I'll go ahead and hide this for the time being. And here is our lines. Now the thing about Big Diagram is that they always have this strong bold line to highlight their building, which makes it really cartoony and makes it stand out from the other background. And the easy way to do it, instead of purely just tracing it all around, is to select all lines and type in curve boolean and just hit outside, which will create the outline of all the curves you selected. Now make sure to place this on a separate layer and say outlines, and maybe the new geometry or the regular lines can be called thin lines. There we go. Now I'll just collapse the layers, type in purge to remove unnecessary layers. Okay, and I'll change the layer color to distinguish which one is which. So, oh, I guess I forgot to do something. Okay, thin lines are out there and outlines are on this layer, or I need to move the line to that layer. Currently it's on default, so I'll move that. Right click on the layer name and change objects layer, and maybe I'll set the color to red so we can clearly visualize it. There, front, right, there we go. Alright, so we'll take that, say export. And when this pops up, save it in a folder somewhere you can remember. Say, big diagram. And I'll change the format to Adobe Illustrator. Now, quick way to do it is to just press tab and hit AA, and it'll put you right at Illustrator. And as for options, we'll just leave everything to normal. Diagram doesn't have a scale, so should be alright, but make sure to keep it consistent when you want to make new additions. Now we'll open up the Illustrator file that we have just exported. And here it is. I'll make the composition a little smaller. Maybe I'll make it about 500 pixels to 500 pixels. And we'll do that. I'll hit Control 0 to make the artboard fit in. And I'll Control X or Edit Cut to put in the clipboard and paste it again. And what this does is it places the illustration right in the middle of your canvas, which is really helpful. Now, if you go over to the Layers tab, you can see that there are two layers. One is the outline in red, and the other is neon green, which is just the thin lines. First off, I'm going to select all by Control A. And change the stroke color to black. Right now you can only see one type of line, but we'll first off go ahead to red layer and click on this area to select everything on that layer and increase the weight to about, say, 3. Now we're almost there, we're pretty close. Now as you might have noticed, some of the diagrams have shadings and the others are just filled in with solid color. As you can see, the way we do it is by using the paint bucket tool. I'm first off gonna go ahead and lock the outline layer because we don't want to touch that, and select only the inside thin lines and go over to paint bucket tool, or you can hit K. Now, some people say this is a cheesy way to do this, but I think it's a quick and dirty way, and it works pretty well, and you'll see why. First off, I'm gonna click on the geometry to activate the tool, and as you can see, using the Live Paint tool, you can fill in the areas that are enclosed by lines, and you can fill them in with different colors. I'll show you how. Right now, we're just in no fill and black outline, but we want the inside to be green courtyard, so we'll sample some nice neon green color and click in the middle. And secondly, we're gonna go over to the dark side of the building and make it slightly dark color. So I'll first refresh that to white color, go over to fill, and we'll shade it in to about, this looks pretty good. Yeah, I'll do that. And type in, click in these two areas. As you can see, they're colored in different areas, colored with different colors. And you can just keep changing colors to start painting in areas that you want to paint. Okay, maybe this side can be a little lighter. And finally, the top obviously gets the most amount of sun, so it can be lightest. Now if you hit V or go back to selection tool and click away, you can see that everything is nice and clean and colored. And that's about it. This is how you create a big diagram. Thanks for watching today's episode of Archi Hacks. I'm currently an intern at Big, and this is actually how we do it here. I've seen a couple tutorials online, and by far this is the fastest and cleanest way to do it. There's a part 2 to this tutorial illustrating how to make arrows and step-by-step diagrams, so if you are interested, be sure to check that out as well. This is it for today. I'll see you guys next time.